Good morning, traders. Today we're going to discuss FS technical analysis without technical indicators. FS technical analysis without technical indicators. All right. In the past, when I start trading first, I wonder how one can trade, okay, without technical indicators. And again, today there are many traders out there, and if they do not see technical indicators, they get lost. They don't know what to do. In this tutorial, I want to show traders how one can trade FS using technical analysis alone without the most popular technical indicators such as the RSI, the CCI, or the MACD, indicators. All right, the first thing first. So one thing you want to understand when you are using MACD or when you are using the stochastic or any momentum oscillator, RSI, CCI, or stochastic, all right, people are looking for overbought and oversold. So when you are performing a technical analysis without those technical indicators, the overbought means that the price is at a resistance level. So though I do not have on my chart here the momentum oscillator, I can determine when the stochastic is overbought, when the CCI is overbought, when the RSI is oversold. I can find out just using channels and trend line. Alright, so for instance, if I put on my chart here, you can see if I connect this high here, where my cursor is, to this high here. Pay attention to that line. It's a bearish trend line, yes or no? Alright, so if the price tries to rally up to that zone, I know that there is a resistance there, so the stochastic will become overbought when the price reaches that resistance zone, because the overbought means that the price is at a resistance zone. On the other hand, if I draw another line connecting, for instance, this low and this one here, it's a rising channel. All right, it's a rising trend line, so you can see price pull back to the edge of a rising channel. I know that the stochastic or any other momentum will become oversold at this point in time. All right, so I can perform a technical analysis without those technical indicators. All right, another thing that I want to say to traders that are struggling to perform a technical analysis without the technical indicator, the best tool to use, okay, is the market geometry, the projection of a rising channel and a projection of a rising channel, declining channel, and horizontal channel. By using the market geometry, you do not need, the momentum oscillator. You do not need the technical, indicator. And you can perform a thorough, more powerful, technical analysis without the technical indicators. All right? So, as you can see, this currency pair, the Australian dollar, Canadian dollar, is quite volatile. In fact, your broker will ask you for bigger stop loss straight away as soon as you enter the trade. This is the first sign that you are entering the shark tank of FS trading. There is a video that we recorded recently and that we titled The Shark Tank of FS Trading. Check it out so you may understand what I'm talking about here. So the price is consolidating between the level of 10564 and the level for 100009. Okay, so from 2011 up to 2012, you can see that this currency pair, the Australian dollar, Canadian dollar, was consolidating between those two key levels. So the momentum oscillator will become overbought when the price reach the upper side of the consolidation, and they will become oversold at this point in time. Now, as I'm telling you, the projection of the channels, market geometry, will allow us to perform a technical analysis without the technical indicator. So as the price dip below that channel, we project the width, we measure the width of our original tunnel, and we project it down. And we know that our momentum oscillators will become oversold as the prior reaches this level of 0.9448, because it's a support level right here. So even if we do not have those technical indicators on our chart, we know that, okay, they are oversold at a support level, and they are overbought. So here, you see that it's going now, it's oversold here, and you become overbought as it reaches the upper level at 10009. All right? So you see that? Very simple. So once again, if you look carefully here, our technical indicator will become overbought, acknowledging this resistance at 10009. Again here. Now, so you may say to me, John, how about MACD? So when we are using MACD, one thing you want to understand, here it is. If I drop, for instance, a trend line like this, right, using MACD. So you may say, how do I use MACD without MACD? All right, you will use a trend line. So MACD will go below its signal line. If the prime break below, okay, a bullish trend line. So whenever the price goes below a common sense bullish trend line, MACD will cross below its signal line in most cases, except if we have a distortion. So price going below a bullish trend line is equal to MACD going below its signal line. All right, but usually when MACD crosses below its signal line, people will sell straight away. But that's not the best way. So MACD crosses below its signal line, it's telling us that wait for the price to confirm that that trend line is a bearish trend line. So break below, retest. So instead of selling straight away as MACD crosses below its signal line, after the price dip below the bullish trend line, you wait for the price to rally up to retest it here, and then you will implement a top-down trading method to sell it. So here, MACD will cross below its signal line, but the best way to sell is here. So we can perform a technical analysis, FS technical analysis, without the technical indicators. If I draw another trend line here, this time I'm drawing a bearish trend line connecting this point where my cursor is and this point here. Here it is, we have a bearish trend line, which I'm going to color now into red. You can see that, okay, if the price breaks above a bearish trend line, is equal to MACD crossing above a signal line. You see now? So MACD crosses above a signal line, does not mean buy straight away. We want to wait for the pullback, so we pull back to retest that bullish trend line. Then we implement a top-down trading method to trade it. All right, but in fact, as I was telling you before, using the market geometry alone, all right, we can perform a thorough, even more powerful technical analysis without the technical indicators. So now that I show you that the price was consolidating between the level of 10564 and the level of 10009, okay, price dip below it, we measure the width of that channel and we project it down. All right, so we will be looking for opportunity to buy bullish trading setup on the lower part of our projected channel, and we'll be ready to take our bullish profit here and implementing a bearish trading strategy on the edge here. You see now, it makes sense. It is also powerful. So by using trend lines, all right, and the market geometry, we can perform FS technical analysis without the technical indicators. It makes sense. It makes sense. It is also powerful. So looking at this currency pair, that is quite difficult to train. I'm warning new traders. The price is now consolidating, currently consolidating between the level of 09448 and 10009. Okay. So bullish trader bought it here using a top-down trading method or a multiple time frame trading method. At the price at this level, some of them will take profit here. If you want to buy, you want to buy above, either here, that's the best place, or it breaks above, all right, retest, and finally support, and then we implement a top-down trading method to buy up. Price going up, we want to watch the media line of our orange channel. We want to trade around key level. You see the media line of that orange channel is coinciding with, okay, this resistance here. All right. So the stochastic will become, or the RSI or momentum oscillator will become overbought, or will stay overbought for a long time. If the stochastic or any momentum oscillator stay overbought for a long time, it means that the price is breaking resistance level. On the other hand, when a stochastic or any momentum oscillator stays oversold for a long time, it means that the price is breaking support level. So our strategy will be break below, retest, and implement a top-down trading method to sell it. So you have to understand that if you start trading first, you love the technical indicators and you are trading them. What I'm telling you now, I'm on a monthly chart. We can apply it on any time frame, even on a 30-minute time frame, on the hourly time frame, and also on a 15-minute time frame. Performing a technical analysis for scalping, for day trading, for swing trading, for position trading, on any time frame, using the price action, the market geometry, the trend line, without the technical indicators. All right, but it is normal for new trader to think of technical indicators all the time, but you want to combine those technical indicators with the market geometry to improve your technical analysis. It makes sense. It is also powerful. All right, so on a 30-minute time frame, as you can see here, the price, again, one more time, you see here, is consolidating, all right, on a 30-minute time frame between the level of 10959, and this level here, bouncing, here it is, pull back, and then we have the media line somewhere here, all right. So the stochastic will become overbought. If it will be oversold at the lower part of this consolidation, it will become overbought here. Now you see it breaks above. That's why I was telling you, if you want to buy, break above, retest, turn around. Now on the 30-minute time frame, here it is. Oops, I move a line. It breaks above that level, and then it retests it here. Now, we will know if you are applying that, if you are using a 30-minute time frame as our trading setup, we will use different time frame. All right, we can go to the 3-minute time frame, 5-minute time frame to zoom into the price to make a better decisions. All right, this is about FS technical analysis without the technical indicators. A lot of traders are losing because they are trading the technical indicator alone and they are not performing the technical analysis without the technical indicators, which means you want to concentrate on the price action using trend line, channel, and market geometry. It makes sense. Now you can see I'm on a 30-minute time frame, same strategy, price breaks above that channel. Where do we set the target on the 30-minute time frame? We measure again one more time. We'll apply market geometry. The projection of the channel is the key for performing a technical analysis without the technical indicator. So we project it up. That's where we will set our target. Boom. You see how we run fast? So this is a good place for a quick scalping because they bought it here. They are willing to take profit here. As a scalping, I will look for a bearish chart pattern on the edge of 10047. And then I'll grab my 15 pip, 10 pip, scalping very fast because I know some traders know that and they will take that profit. The bullish trader who bought it here will be willing to take some profit here. So quickly, I grab my pips as a day trader, as a scalper, and then I move on. If I want to buy again, game on. Break a bull. Retest, all right. Turn around. We can also buy near the media line of a channel, but either the lower part of the channel or near the media line. So we go in up, goes above the media line, retest, we take it to the upper side level. Goes above the next level, break above, retest, right? Here it is, that's it. You see now? Now if it goes above the level of 10047, well, we have our measuring stick. Here we have it again here. So the stochastic or any momentum oscillator will become overbought at this point in time. This is a convergent point. We know that, And most technical indicator, all right, will stay overbought for a long time here because the price was going now for some time. Stochastic will become overbought at a resistance level of the first channel here and will stay overbought for a long time. And before here it come back down, it's going down, it's looking for a support level. Stochastic oversold, momentum oscillator oversold. it means that the price is supportable. Then it will become oversold here. Here again, it will become oversold. It will become overbought here. So we can perform a technical analysis on any time frame without the technical indicator. One more time. You may say, how about MACD? You know the drill, the trend line. On the 30-minute time frame, you see this bearish trend line, probably above it. It means that MACD crosses above its signal line. Okay? Here, the common centralized caput is indicating to us that MACD is crossing below its signal line. Here it is. Right below the common central line, best place to sell, retest, and then we take it down. It makes sense? All right? Price is above, okay, a rising trend line. MACD will be rising, probably above the zero line. Okay? All right, it makes sense? This is about FS, technical analysis, without technical indicator. So you may say to me, George, I love the 50-minute time frame. You can do exactly the same thing on the 50-minute time frame, and you will improve your day trading, scalping, and swing trading, okay, decision. If you have any question or suggestion, put in the comment section. And in due course, I will record another video to answer your specific question. We are the TSTW24 traders talking about FS, technical analysis, without technical indicators. Happy trading to you all, and speak to you soon.